Hi, I'm Lars Skaar with SAS and solution architect from the Nordics. And as you will see soon, I'm passionate about DevOps. And thanks for watching this video. I hope you are excited as I am to see how we can use CICD to automate the migration from SAS Enterprise to SAS Viya Studio Flow. Basically, I want to show three things: migration itself and a way of validating what we migrated by comparing what we got in the Enterprise Guide environment with what we get in the SAS Viya Studio Flows environment. And finally, a way to automate this process through CICD on the Git management platform, and specifically on GitHub, as it is a widespread platform that many have access to. And the same approach can be used with Azure DevOps, GitLab, Bitbucket, and many others. So we want to migrate an Enterprise Sky project. It could be multiple, but for the sake of this, there's only one. And we use Git as a way of to get it across, and use GitHub to automate the process of setting up the environment, importing the Enterprise Sky projects, and finally validate that it works as expected. And you may ask, why automation of migration is such a big deal, and by the end of the video you will see how fast this go and how little effort I need to put into this once I made the necessary preparations. And what we see in the field is that you typically do your migrations many times and with many Enterprise Sky project or EOS flows. So by automating this, you will save a lot of time and effort, and you will see later in the show how much time the actual migration took, and you can compare that how much time you would spend if you did this manually. So with that introduction, let's look at the Enterprise Guide flow we want to get across. So we want to migrate this Enterprise Guide project to a SAS Viya Studio Flow in Viya. And as you see, it's a nice user interface. And we'll just take this for a spin. As you see, it runs nicely, no complaints. And this is tested and deemed useful. It creates lookup tables based on the financial tables. So we want to compare with the lookup tables we got here with what we got on the in SAS Viya after we migrated. So we got to compare those. And this provides a practical and efficient way of validating that they work the same, produce the same results. And this we want to automate. And we use Git as a way to get the Enterprise Guide project across, as well as expected results of the lookup tables. So the nice thing is that Enterprise Guide comes with a pretty good user interface to Git, as you can see here. So now it sees that we have changed this Enterprise Guide project. We have the data from the lookup tables as expected results, and they're ready to be staged and committed. And once committed, we can push those changes back to the central repository. So we'll do that now. We just hit this stage all thing. We will give a nice comment that one should do when you commit. So we're committing to the local repository, and we push those changes to the central repository, to GitHub. So now this is done. So we can take a look at what happens in GitHub, as GitHub actions will be triggered based on an update of the repository. And this is the default behavior of GitHub Actions. So now we're in the GitHub Action view. So you will see that there is a small colored circle that goes around on this workflow, which means an action workflow in GitHub has been triggered. And this has a nice visual, which shows the boxes shows what jobs are running in the workflow. And these jobs run steps as defined in the workflow, and we'll check them out later. For now, I just want to show you how they were triggered and that they do follow this workflow. Remember, they were triggered when we pushed changes from our SAS 9.4 Enterprise Guide environment into our central Git repository on GitHub. So while this is running, we can take a peek at what the workflow actually does. And the first, let's take at this prepared target. So this does, well, two things. First, it cleans up target, which means it deletes what we created before. So in this particular case, it deletes the Enterprise Guide job we imported earlier. And this one takes advantage of a set of tools they call Python Viya tools, or actually tools made in Python to talk to Viya. And they are available on GitHub as well. So they can be downloaded, free to use, and very nice tools for this purpose, for automation and to do stuff with Viya. So we're using this login to authenticate to the environment, and then we're deleting content from the area that the Enterprise Guide projects are imported to. So, and after that, we're doing prepare target, is essentially doing some configuration on the environment, so it behaves the same each time. So, and this is also quite convenient, so you have ways of setting up the environment consistently through configuration paths. So that's prepare target. Import, that's one thing. Import the Enterprise Guide projects. And it actually does this through a command called import EG project that comes from the content assessment tools that you can download. Content assessment is something you do on your 9.4 environment to get an overview of the environment, and also as some kind of assessment on the state for migration to SAS Viya. And one of the tools that it comes with is this bulk import on EG project or SAS packages. So we run that against this this CSV file, which I believe is here, which is just a CSV file with a list of paths where the Enterprise Guide project is. So this could be, you can have as many as you want. And you typically can get them from content assessment or from your own assessment on what you think is ready to be migrated. It is as simple as that, and it just gets in. And then finally, we validate. And validate, we import the data, you know, we prepared the expected results, so we get them in and get them across to an area that is accessible to the environment. And then we do the actual validation. And that's also done, you can see here, I'll show you some nice tools that we use. This is the Python Viya tools, also have this called REST API, which I think is really nice. And you can access an exposed endpoint that do certain things for us. In this particular case, it generates SAS code from a flow. Because we need it to be SAS code, and then we can run that SAS code. And then we run the test program that actually does a proc compare from what we got in the new environment to what we got from Enterprise Guide. So, that's it, actually. And one interesting thing, you can see that this is done now already. It took us 2 minutes and 4 seconds. We didn't need to help it in any way. Everything is prepared, everything's done automatically. So now we're actually all good when it comes to this particular flow from this Enterprise Guide project, and we could consider letting it live in the SAS Viya environment and do its business there, and have it retired in the Enterprise Guide environment. Still, let us take a peek at how it ended up in the SAS Viya environment and see how it compares to the original. We know that it creates the same results, so it would be nice to see how it actually looks like. So as you can see, the flow looks fairly similar in SAS Studio to what we had in Enterprise Guide. Most tasks in Enterprise Guides, like these things, they get translated to what we call steps in Studio Flow. Like the query builder gets translated to a query step in Studio Flow. And sometimes the tasks get translated to SAS code due to not being able to translate to a step at this stage. And this will improve on a regular basis as new migration comes available to SAS Studio. And we have already validated this, so we know that this flow produces the same results or data, that is. Run it and see that it runs nicely. So it does the same thing as Enterprise Guide did, at least in terms of creating the data. To automate validation of that, I made this test program which is essentially using proc compare for the basis expect results that we had from the Enterprise Guide environment, and we compare that against the actual result that we got in this environment. And then we can run that, and as you will see, this one, in this case, we'll also get this nice report that shows the outcome of the proc compare function. And in this case, it is all good. But if it was any discrepancies, that would be shown. And I'll also test against the return code and do this abort cancel, which makes this exit in a way that GitHub actually will catch it. So it is actually as simple as that. So with that, I will conclude the video and encourage you to try this out. This GitHub is available. This repository is available on GitHub. So you can find it there. It's called Lars@SAS-auto-eg-via. We'll send you the link in the description of the video. So with that, thank you for your attention, and see you later then.